love, if it happens anywhere, happens here. In the soft rain, the frothing blossom, the first new leaves. Nothing else matters. Go on, persist, try again. The frail old man in the black denim jacket, he's had 20 years and died himself, recuperating from an illness, looking no more than a bunch of sticks propping up his own skin. He's sitting in the sun on the cathedral green, bony, wizened, whittled, like an otter or a horse drinking the sun's warmth in.
The whale. She had made her way to shore over chalk beds and sandbanks to form this swanning beach death all the strangers came to see. A Payne's grey sort of wreckage, slumped unrestorably, all scraped and scarred, a latticework of skin on show, and sprawled like a drunk left over for us, almost relaxed in the surf. Was she surprised by death? Rushed in beneath all those bright sweeps of solder-coloured water, learning all our new desires. A week's tides could not lift her, and they brought trucks, and then saws.
The heron, haggard and slow, comes flying down Newmarket Road at rush hour in a kind of lope, as if he was put together with bits of balsa wood and bedsheet and some long out of date house paint, following the centre line. I swear his wings were so broad their tips almost touched the spreading leaves of the flowering horse chestnuts. He was heading for the middle of town, and when I craned my neck to see him, I'd like to say he was still following the road, but he took that moment to veer off slowly and vanish between the trees.
The bittern. We moored at Howe Hill in loose light and birdsong. Two marsh harriers bowled up their thermal. One heron made its pike staff in the sedgewall. Evening leaked west as, one by one, some human singers let their song drift down to fill the field and stave, the big house concert over now. Did they step out to hear the geese weave their sorrows and silhouettes? Settled then, the humans and birds, when a new sound underpinned us, like a bottleneck when blown like this. A bass whoomph, or far off foghorn unplaced, lost beneath things like love, repeating through the night for us.
A small bird broke from the stone, vanished in at another hole in the deep, dead cold. Here they nest, these almost heart-shaped, soft things, the size of a child's fist, the colour of dried grass or wisps of dark straw, nameless, flying over our heads.
The seal. We almost missed you in the Bure, boulder-headed as the river bent towards Acle. There you were, all half-term nonchalance, fishing. And we were shocked how far you'd come to blink and watch our boat purling through the big afternoon. We smiled, and then you were gone. River god, sleek night bones, your soaked trunk twisting through ochre waters, so special and remote and even-handed, taking what you want of bream or perch or roach. That night, I dreamed you drew through the shining mud and raised yourself among low trees, your dousing coat still sleek and wet, stepping out with that whiskered smile and the fleur-de-lis of your teeth.